Good evening, everyone. Today is Sunday. The time here is 7:11. May I greet everyone a pleasant good evening. Wilhelmina is here again live on Facebook. As I've said to you guys, today is Sunday. My online virtual office opens 7 days a week. I only come live online when a buyer's mandate or buyer ask questions and he didn't even comprehend what he's reading on my virtual page. The procedure is already online in front of you guys. Whether you buy gold in Conakry, Guinea, whether you buy gold in Sierra Leone and in Mali, the procedure are all the same. The procedure means, if you are watching Mr. Buyer or Buyer's Mandate, the procedure means that you are going to introduce yourself. And the procedure is online. It says the carats, the purity, the mode of payment. That is the procedure that we are putting online. Now, we are selling to you directly, Mr. Buyer, that the gold is 23 carats. From 22.54 equals 23 carats. The purity from 95, 96, 97, 98, that is an offer to you to sell. We are selling directly to you, Mr. Buyer. Now, the origin of the gold is coming from Conakry, Guinea, Sierra Leone, and Mali. So which one, Mr. Seller, you're going to secure? Now, when you watch my posting, that is my virtual online page. When you read it, digest it properly. You watch the video. Every video that I have, I put everything. The gold origin from Conakry, Mali, and Sierra Leone. The carat is 22.54, okay? Plus, meaning to say, it's almost 24 carats. The purity from 95, 96, 97, 98. That is an offer. The origin, the mode of payment is not CIF, it's not SBLC, it's not Black Fund, it's not standard letter of credit. This is FOB, cash bank to bank. Why are you going to us is BLC? Meaning to say you don't have cash. You are going to us for credit. And it would take 35 days to process your paper. Because your bank and my seller's bank will communicate each other. You never know that your bank would reject. And my seller bank also will screen your background. So why are you asking for credit? So meaning to say you don't have the money, you don't have cash. Yes, you have a solid asset, but you don't have a liquid asset. That is why you're going to borrow money in your bank using the gold as collateral. It wouldn't work at all. You have to be prepared that you have money in order to pay what you are buying. You are buying money to make money. So if you don't have the money, how are you able to make money? So therefore, you're asking our products to leverage, and then you're going to resell it to your end customer, and then you get the profit. That is the time you pay my seller. It wouldn't work at all. Now, remember, Mr. Buyer, the golden rules. He who has the gold makes the rules. So the country has the gold. So the country is making the rules, not you. Do not make your rules to ask us to bring gold in your country, and then you when the gold arrived in your country, that is the time you're going to pay. You never know you're a criminal. You never know you're a thief. You never know you're a kidnapper. You never know you're going to default the payment. No, we don't do business like that. You watch Wilhelmina every video. When you see the full corporate offer in front of you, on this video, click below, subscribe on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube. you listen very carefully on this video. If you don't listen to me, you are not a buyer. Don't be excited, because we are not excited to deal with you if you don't have this. Mm-hmm. We will be only excited if you can afford to pay. Now, Mr. Buyer, the full corporate offer is already in front of you, but you are not paying attention. Even the brokers, they don't pay attention. A minute he saw, well, I mean, they're excited. No, you don't need to be excited, because to me, I'm not excited at all. I would be excited, Mr. Buyer, if you read the full corporate offer, then you send a formal letter of intent to purchase coming from you, your company letterhead, your address, your email, right? Your WhatsApp number. And you need to specify, what are you looking? Are you going to buy gold to make into jewelry? Are you going to buy gold to make into spare parts on mobile phone? Here, are you going to buy gold to make into jewelry? Or are you going to buy gold to refine it into 99.99? So you are buying unrefined. Don't be confused, Mr. Buyer. Don't be confused. You are going to buy gold to refine it into different uses. It is your responsibility. It is your business. Our business, here's the product coming from the mines. The bars is coming from the mines. Inspect it. You like it. We will taste the gold to a local refinery. Then you will get the assay report that the gold is 22.54, that the purity is 95, 96, 97, something like that. And there is a cost when you assay the gold to the local refinery of $100 per kilo. So make sure you have the money. Make sure. Right. So when you send a formal letter of intent, Mr. Buyer, Wilhelmina will screen you. Wilhelmina will call you. You have to send the letter of intent to purchase attention to Wilhelmina, because Wilhelmina will be the one to validate you. Wilhelmina will be the one to determine which seller I'm going to put you, Conakry, Sierra Leone, or Mali. Then when I'm satisfied with your letter of intent, then that is the time I will inform you that I will put you to Sierra Leone, I will put you to Conakry, or I will put you to Mali. Then that's the time your letter of intent, I'm going to send it to my head office, my seller head office, that let us proceed the contract, because I already validated you. Now, before, I'm going to advise the head office, I need to see your business registration. I need to see your importation license. I need to see your passport copy. I need to see your bank statement that you have available fund, the value of your order. Without that, you will be rejected. Right, this is not CIF, this is FOB. Then when I receive it, your letter of intent and your requirement, I'm going to send it to the head office that I already validated this buyer, that here is the buyer's business registration, here is the buyer's importation license, here's the buyer passport copy, and here's the buyer's the proof of fund. Then the seller will send you a letter of confirmation of your order. Dear Mr. Buyer, thank you that you talk to Wilhelmina Ford, based in Australia, our international mandate. We hereby confirm your order. So my seller will send you the contract, because I'm going to gather all your vital information. We don't send blank contract, SPA. I don't release the SPA blank. I don't solicit at all. I am going to gather your vital information. Don't be scared, Mr. Buyer. Your vital information will be intact between you and the seller and Wilhelmina, because I am the gatekeeper. I am going to gather your vital information. Then that is the time I'm going to say to Mr. Seller of mine that let us proceed. Then we will send you landing visa as an invitee. Now, Mr. Buyer, you have an option. Mm-hmm. May I ask you first, how long you've been searching for gold? How long? How many months? And how many online joker broker you've been spoken? I called him joker broker because the real buyer would not float around. The real buyer would not win the shop. Yeah? So you are window shopping and all the brokers landed into my hand. All right? Now, Mr. Buyer, I have a buyer from India. He was been floating around and he sent his business registration. He sent his importation license, but he deceived himself. He deceived us. He doesn't have the money. So what is the point? So I told this buyer that I thought you have the money because you said you are going to buy gold if Obi. And he wanted us to bring gold in India without giving his credential. And I told him, I want to see your proof of fund, bank statement. Now he just sent me an email and also on WhatsApp because I ignore him. And he said, Madam, I received the contract, I review it, but I don't have the money. What a bullshit buyer, excuse my language. I don't have the money, Madam, but I want to have a credit. Please help me. Then when I receive your gold, then that's the time I will pay. I'm going to resell your gold to my buyer. I said, no, we don't do that. Now another buyer from South Africa. He has been watching my video. Two videos, he said. I fully understood. I listened to your video. And I want you to bring the gold to South Africa in my office. Then that is the time I will pay. No. This buyer is very tricky. And his picture is the face of animal. And I sent him the voice. And I told him, you know who is Wilhelmina. And you know we are transparent. And why you hide your face? Why your profile on your Facebook, a pictures of animal, lion. So why are you hiding your face? To me, you are not really a buyer, because a real buyer would not hide his face. Mr. Buyer, believe me, if you talk to Wilhelmina live, you will be rejected, because when you come to Wilhelmina, I make sure that you are real. Now, this buyer from South Africa, I told him, good luck. Yeah, he said to me, we are a big buyer. Tell your seller to bring gold in South Africa. Then that's the time I will pay. I said, no, we're not interested. You never know, that buyer is scrupulous. I already have a doubt because on his profile, his picture is a lion picture on his profile. Why he hide his face? Wilhelmina is not hiding her face. Wilhelmina is live. Wilhelmina is a true person. My seller is a true person. So Mr. Buyer, you are very tricky. You are. How many buyers I have rejected? Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of them. Why? To me, they are deceitful. They are deceitful. A real buyer would not deceive himself. Only fake buyer deceive himself. He wanted to get the products without any putting single cents. Now, Mr. Buyer, if you're watching my video, I think you're a bigger. Why? Why are you a bigger? Why you ask us to bring gold to your destination without knowing who you are? Why you ask us to bring gold to your destination without putting single cents? To me, you're a bigger. My seller is not a bigger. My seller has been in gold business for many years. He's not begging the government to get the license to apply as a mining license. Do you think the government will give him for free? My seller didn't beg, and he has to pay $45,000 just to get the license. And he has to hire the gemologist to find out how many tons of gold deposit on his property. And my seller doesn't beg to his worker to work for free. And my seller would not beg to the importer of rice to deliver 200 bags to the mines in Sigiri. So the importer will not give 200 bags of rice if my seller have no cash to pay. So to me, you as the buyer asking to bring gold in Dubai and bring gold to Singapore or in Hong Kong, to me, you are a bigger. You are a scrupulous buyer. I'm sorry to say this. I have to be tough with you, Mr. Buyer. You've been floating around many months and still you think you can get gold CIF. No. Our selling price is premium. You go on the world market, we sell spot price, less 8%. Mr. Buyer, I'm sorry to say this. To me, you are just playing games. Don't play games with us, because we are not a game player here. This is a true business. If you play games, then you have a problem meeting this woman if you're playing games, because I'm very strict and straightforward. Don't be annoyed. Don't say that, oh, Wilhelmina is arrogant. No, I'm not arrogant. I'm just telling the truth. You are not telling the truth. You're covering your face. Why on your Facebook, the picture is on, your picture is lion. So to me, it's a red flag. It's a red flag. So you should not hide your face if you are a real buyer. Now another buyer, I just finished talking to this buyer, buyer's agent. He said, Madam, I have a buyer. Tell your seller to bring gold to Dubai. I said, no. Excuse me. Who is your buyer? I want to talk to your buyer and I'm going to interview your buyer. And he said to me, I have a buyer. Okay. How long your buyer using you? And I said to Rahid, Rahid, you've been following me. You have to read. Okay, I'm not here to educate you. If you're a broker, you read and digest it properly. Because everything is online. I put everything for the buyer easy to understand that this is money you are buying, Mr. Buyer. You are not buying banana. Even banana, you have to pay for it. Gold is money. You have to pay for it. Gold is not for credit. This is FOB bank-to-bank payment because of money laundering and gold laundering. Now, I was talking to Rahid a few hours ago. And I said to him, I've been to Dubai. I was in Dubai before lockdown. I interviewed 8 joker buyers. They are all joker to me. They're asking for CIF. Do you understand what the CIF means? Cost insurance only. So you are asking my seller to pay the cost insurance and you're sitting down in your ass waiting for the gold to come to you. No, we don't do that. Before the gold leave the country of origin, we need to have your background. We need to check your background. We need to know your business registration. Wilhelmina will require you to submit your business registration. Show Wilhelmina your importation license. Show Wilhelmina your passport copy. Show Wilhelmina your bank statement. Then I will believe you're a buyer. Yes? Then when I receive your documentation, I will call you. And I will tell you, okay, I receive your vital information. I'm going to send this to the head office. I'm going to advise my head office to proceed the contract. Now, Mr. Buyer, you will receive a letter of confirmation of your order. There, Mr. Buyer, thank you very much for your inquiry through our international marketing consultant based in Australia. Now, your order has been confirmed. Yes. We will reserve your order, we will allocate your order subject for your arrival. So you will receive a letter of acknowledgement and you will receive the contract because I am gathering your vital information. Once we send you the contract, attached with my seller's mining license, attached of my seller's articles, right? And your business registration must be attached on the contract. And I will send it to you, all your information which you provided me. You review that, then you sign the contract, you return it back to me, and then I will send it to the head office, then we will proceed. Then that is the time we will issue the landing visa, that you are a company guest and your order has been reserved, subject for your arrival. Now, Mr. Buyer, on every video, it says, do not travel without invitation. Do not travel without Wilhelmina. Why? If Wilhelmina would be with you, Wilhelmina can assist you 100%. Now, Mr. Buyer, when I travel with you, I do charge my extra service. I am not an agency. I'm not. I am here to facilitate between buyers and seller. So you are using my extra service. If you cannot afford my extra service to me, therefore you cannot afford to pay the products. Now, You have an option, Mr. Buyer. If you don't want to pay my extra service, you can travel. I will monitor your movement, right? So if there is an issue, do not ask Wilhelmina, because Wilhelmina will be very far from you. I live in Australia, and you're going to travel to Sierra Leone. You're going to be travel to Conakry. You're going to travel to Mali when I place you to any particular seller that I handle with. Now, recently, Mr. Buyer, I have transaction successful because I was on the ground. You only stay 9 working days. Okay? The gold that you reserve, you're going to come to the office, you inspect, you look at the gold. If you have a gold tester, you bring it. My seller has a gold tester, but if you have a gold tester, you bring it, you can taste it in the office. And then you're happy, then we will bring it to the refinery. I'm going to put you first to Conakry, right? Any buyer, I'm going to put you to Conakry, Sierra Leone, and Mali. I will distribute buyers to my different sellers. Now, Mr. Buyer, which one you like? If you are in Dubai, Emirates now is in operation. Emirates travel to Conakry twice a week. Mm-hmm. So if you are in Dubai, you can travel to Conakry to meet my head office, the Godfather. Okay? Now, when you travel to Conakry, you are VIP. You will be a VIP of Mineral Consulting Group of Company. Mm-hmm. So you will be picked up by the company driver. And then you're going to book, you have to book your hotel. I can recommend you to stay at the Royal Kulum Hotel, because the Royal Kulum Hotel is across the Central Bank. Mm-hmm. You stay there from my head office, 8 blocks away from the Central Bank. Mm-hmm. So now, Mr. Buyer, which one you like? Do you want Wilhelmina be with you on the ground, or you just travel by yourself? You have 2 options. But if I'll travel with you, yes, I do charge my extra service. I do charge to cover my airline ticket, my travel insurance, hotel accommodation, and spending money. That's all I'm going to charge, an extra. But if you cannot afford to pay my extra to me, it's a red flag, meaning to say you don't have the money to pay. Mm-hmm. Okay, meaning to say you don't have money to pay for the gold. That is my logic, analogy. That is my business psychology. When I psychologize you and you said, oh, well, Wilhelmina, I cannot afford, meaning to say you don't have the money. Because 10 kilos to start with, Mr. Buyer, our selling price is tax inclusive. Now, Mr. Buyer, I'm going to look at the gold today. Today is July 12. Don't bank on it, because the price of gold is fluctuate. Just a moment. I'm going to see the price of gold today. Just bear with me. So don't bank on it, because the price of gold, it fluctuate. Now, yesterday, the price of gold was high. Now, it's down. Okay? The price of gold today is 57,845.94. Last night, the price of gold was 58,200. So it fluctuates. So don't bank on it. Okay? So now, Mr. Buyer, we are selling our gold to you. 50,000 per kilo. On 10 kilos to start with. 50,000, 1, 2, 3 times 10 kilos. That is $500,000. Do you have a $500,000? This is the price. Mm-hmm. 10 kilos. Now, you're going to say, oh, very expensive, Wilhelmina. Well, you are buying precious item. Do you understand the meaning of precious? Means very expensive, because it's precious. There is a value on it. So, Mr. Buyer, you don't need to pay taxes. We covered the taxes. We cover the shipping cost, but you pay the insurance. So which one you like, Mr. Buyer? The insurance of the value of 500 $1,000 times 1%, that is only $5,000 on the total sale value, the insurance. So you are a winner, Mr. Buyer. You are. So there is no surprises. I know you've been window shop. You have been offered very cheap. That is gross. When you arrive on that particular country, there is a surprises. So Mr. Buyer, which one you like? 50,000 per kilo, tax inclusive, shipping cost is there. We cover the shipping cost except the insurance. So Mr. Buyer, you are a winner. Now bank now, Mr. Buyer, because the gold is down. Okay, 57,884, and we give you $50,000 per kilo, and you have a profit. You have a discount of 7,000. You get the discount. So when you resell it, whatever the price of tomorrow, or you keep it, then if the price turn to 60,000 or 58,59, you're a winner. Now, Mr. Buyer, I know that the trial is very crucial. We don't know you and you don't know us. Mm-hmm. However, you already saw Wilhelmina and you already saw the procedure, who is my seller. So you are confident. Rather than floating around, talking to different brokers, you have to pay your broker, Mr. Buyer. If you are dealing with chain of broker, you have to pay the commissions of your broker, because we don't pay double commission and I don't deal brokers. Why are we going to deal brokers? I already put online. That is why I put everything online, so that we will eliminate those time waster. We will deal directly to you, Mr. Buyer. I have been giving the brokers an opportunity, but broker doesn't read. I just rejected this broker. And I said to Rahid, my gosh, Rahid, you've been following Wilhelmina. Still, you don't read. And you keep asking questions. If you are a professional broker or buyer's agent, you have to read. You have to digest it. Because to me, when I handle my seller, I even interview my seller. I even ask my seller a lot of information before I handle my seller. So I went to Africa, I meet my seller. So I am 100% confident. We have gold and diamond, but how are you able to pay, Mr. Buyer? How? And if you keep on bargaining to me, you are not a buyer. A real buyer doesn't talk too much, only bullshit buyer talk too much. Excuse my language. Mm-hmm. Because I have to educate you, Mr. Buyer. You've been losing money, right? You are. You've been losing money. One guy from Ghana, he called me. Please, madam, do not talk about Ghana. I said, yeah, I was being screwed in your country. Yeah. The gentleman called me. And he thought, I don't know, I was in their country, I was being scammed big time. Mm-hmm. That is the reason why I warn every seller, do not muck around with the buyer and Wilhelmina. Because if you muck around with me and Wilhelmina and the office of my seller, and you muck around, yes, I'm going to blog you. I was being blogged and I was being bashed by a scrupulous buyer. Well, good luck. I was being bashed by a lady from South Africa, a broker. Well, I wish them good luck. I'm not scared, because I never received any single cents from those buyers. I was being screwed in Ghana. Many times I'm telling you guys, because I have to share it with you, so that when you arrive on that country, Wilhelmina is telling the truth. Yes, Wilhelmina is telling the truth. When I was in Accra, I was being screwed big time. Mm-hmm. That is the reason why this buyer from Ghana, he called me last night. Mm-hmm. Madam, you ruined the image of Ghana. So no, I didn't. Your people are scrupulous, I told this gentleman. Your people are scrupulous. No matter how I educate, their eyes is bigger than a dollar. They're devious. Yes. That is why, Mr. Buyer, believe me, don't be trapped by your bargaining method. We will give you the good deal when you convince Wilhelmina, because I am going to be with you, and I'm not going to allow you to travel alone so that you will not be duped, right? Even though, Mr. Bayer, I was in Ghana, I was with Eric Blasco and Mr. Martin from Mexico, I was even screwed. That was my biggest lesson. I learned from many mistakes. Now this time, Mr. Bayer, if you're watching Wilhelmina, make sure you have the money, because I am charging you my extra service. And I want you to be honest yourself, and I want you to be honest with Wilhelmina, because my services is very important to your business. My sellers also need my services. I am not an agency. I am not here to teach people. Most of you brokers, madam, teach me how to do business. No, I am not here to teach you. Read it, and if you comprehend, you apply that to yourself. Because no one teach me. I have to learn in the hard way. And I have to help this buyer and the seller. I've been in marketing for 36 years, buying and selling exactly the same. There is no shortcut. Mr. Buyer, do not shortcut the destiny. Do not shortcut your journey. If you shortcut your journey, yes, you will end into disaster. Why, Mr. Buyer, if you want to shortcut? Meaning to say, when you come to any particular country, you pretend that you have money, and then when you arrive, you bargain and you ask for CIF. The Ministry of Mines will not allow any foreigner this time to take their property out of the country without full payment. Now, you were being scammed before because you were being offered to pay taxes. Don't do that, Mr. Buyer. Don't. You have to pay the product plus tax. However, in our position, I was the one who suggested to my seller, when the price of gold, because we are selling premium, we sell $50,000 per kilo, we absorb the tax. The seller is going to pay taxes and the shipping cost. How? When you ask the gold, you make a partial down payment of maybe $10,000 or $20,000. Your partial, you will be given a receipt. So you're going to stay in Africa 9 working days. So out of the balance, let's say you buy 10 kilos of 500, you make a down payment of 20,000, okay? Minus 20,000. So the balance is 480,000. So you need to transfer that bank to bank on that day, because you have to wait for 9 working days. You will be given a receipt, the commercial invoice. So when you transfer the payment, before you travel, Mr. Buyer, by the way, you need to inform your bank that you are going to transfer payment in Africa, because Africa is a red flag. Red flag of money laundering and gold laundering. So you have the contract. You say, okay, Mr. Bank Manager, I'm going to travel to Africa. I'm going to buy valued goods. So your manager aware that you are going to transfer payment after 2 days or 3 days, then my seller's bank will also be advised that he is expecting payment from the buyer, let's say from Dubai. So both bank is aware. That is why we need to know who you are. That is why we need your business registration, and you will get all the document from my head office. We will provide you, because the bank say, okay, who is the seller? Yeah, who is it? How are you going to buy gold or diamond? That is why we provide you everything. Now, there's a lot of buyer has been deceived. Buyers are deceitful as well. And the seller. The seller would not explain to you like this. So be careful, those seller who offer you cheap price. Mr. Buyer, gold and diamond is not cheap. There is a value on it, right? I was talking to a gentleman, and he has an office in the Philippines. Yeah? And he is from Morocco. He lost $2 million when he was in Ghana. And now he become friends of me. He has been following my blog, my page. And 3 days ago, he buzzed me on Messenger. He said, you know, Mrs. Ford, I've been watching you for many months. And I went to Ghana. Mm-hmm. And I said to him, how is your business in Ghana? I lost $2 million. I said, what happened? The gold didn't arrive. I made the payment. I gave it to the seller, and the gold didn't arrive. This gentleman is very rich, but he lost $2 million. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That is the reason why I rejected buyers. So, madam, I'm looking gold to buy in Ghana. I said, no, I'm not dealing with Ghana. Ghana is a nice country. I don't have any problem. Only the people who sell gold, they are devious. They are. Now, since then, I think in 2013, the government changed the ruling. You cannot take the gold out of Ghana without full payment, because the government is losing an income. Most of the seller, the small miner, they cut corner. Oh, you pay taxes. No, Mr. Buyer, if you're going to be asked to pay taxes, believe me, you are waiting for disaster. The custom will not allow you to take their products without custom clearance. Most of the seller in Ghana, they are trying to shortcut. They're trying to smuggle gold as well. Mm-hmm. So if someone offer you, don't. I'm telling you, don't. I've been in Africa, my transaction is successful. I always guide the buyer. Do not shortcut. And my seller, please don't shortcut as well. So that is the reason why my seller is really, really is scared of me as well. Because when I get angry, I swear. Yeah? I warn everybody. When I bring the buyer, please do your job, Mr. Seller, do your job. That is the reason why I do charge my extra service. Now, Mr. Buyer, I think I already explained it to you. Don't rush. This video is for you. And you're going to learn a lot out of this video. I know you were being burned out. I was also burned out. But I learned from my bad experience. I am sharing you my bad experience in order for you and me to learn to each other. Those jokers online have no idea. They are just collecting information. They think they can get the commission. Yes, they will get the commission when their buyer is real. Because when I interview the buyer, Mr. Buyer, if I interview you and you're dealing with so many joker broker, believe me, you will be rejected. Mm-hmm. There was a buyer that I met in Conakry. There were four of them. And before the lockdown, those buyer that already on the ground, we don't deal buyers with no invitation. But because the buyer has been locked down, I might consider. Mm-hmm. But his terms and condition, he said to me, bring the gold to Central Bank. I said, no, you need to come to the office first. You inspect what you order. Okay, then when you inspect, because you have to come to the office, my seller has an office. Mm-hmm. So when you inspect the gold, then you're going to say, okay, because I'm going to organize, that's what I told the buyer, I'm going to organize that you have been locked down. Because if I'm not going to tell my head office that you have been locked down, and you just been there, and you've been frustrated, my seller would not touch you. So I told this buyer, okay, I will tell my seller that you have been locked down and I will consider, I'm going to pressure my seller. But this buyer said, oh, no, tell your seller to bring gold in Central Bank, reject. Because that buyer is very stubborn. I already met him. Mm-hmm. And I told Mr. Buyer, you know you're a businessman. If I come to your office or your store, and I'm going to tell you, bring the gold to Australia. Do you think you're going to give it to me? And you don't know me? And you know what he said? No. Well, you're talking. So I told this buyer, think about it. You've been locked down. And to stay in Africa, every day it costs money. To stay in Royal Kulum, the hotel is $250 per night. So I told the buyer, think about it. You come back when you're ready. Mm-hmm. Simple thing I asked him, your passport copy and proof of fund, bank statement that you have money. And I will solve your problem, I told this buyer. And I'm going to solve your problem because I have the power to pressure my seller. Yeah, I told him. So I told him, think about it. Mm-hmm. That is how business, don't shortcut, Mr. Buyer. Don't put your terms and condition. Your rules is not really acceptable. You follow the rules of the government. As I've said to you many times on my video, he who has the gold makes the rules. That you are the buyer, you follow the rules of the government. Without that, believe me, you fail. Don't believe on seller selling you 35, 36, 37. That is only gross. But when you arrive, believe me, you will be trapped. There was a seller who offered 27. And the buyer talked to me. And I said, yeah, I know this seller. Mm-hmm. And I called this seller, why are you offering 27? And that is deceiving. So the buyer was thankful. You know what the seller say? I just want to trap him. No, don't do that. Mm. Don't do that. So Mr. Buyer, I think I already explained. This video is a very good educational for you. Believe me, I can guarantee you 100%. And if you follow the golden rules, this time you will not fail. But if you are crooked and you don't follow and you stick to your rules, I can guarantee you'll fail. Thank you very much. Have a pleasant good evening.